Witają Państwa Marcin Wąk
i Janusz Janowski.
Mówiliśmy sobie w poprzednich spotkaniach ze sztuką o końcu wieku XIX.
During our previous conversations concerning art, we spoke about the end of the 19th century, which was marked by the outbreak of World War I in 1914. This is an important time period concerning art, as many artists were going to war, dying or going through great trauma, which is difficult to imagine in today's day and age. This is an event that shaped and changed artists' perceptions of day-to-day life, as well as their perceptions of art itself. It is important to bring up surrealism, which is very heavily tied to the end of the First World War in
1918.
Tak, rzeczywiście. I nawet można powiedzieć, że ta trauma pierwszej wojny światowej.
It can be said that the trauma from the First World War made significant imprint in the Polish art scenes and culture scenes. On one hand, Dadaism, the futuristic artists, contested reality and order with contempt and a feeling of superiority. Surrealists, however, were perceived to have been going in the other direction. They were not displaying such an aggressive attitude towards the existing description of reality. They were focused on trying to build a new reality, an escape route of sorts. It is crucial to note, however, that similarly to other artistic trends such as Dadaism, Futurism, Russian Constructivism and Surrealism was also a revolutionary trend. The scripture, which was created in 1924, was named the Surrealistic Revolution. From the very beginnings of the communist establishment, its motives were clear.
Akcent położony na rewolucyjność.
I właśnie, warto, kiedy mówisz o tej rewolucji.
What is also important to note is that surrealism itself began not with a brush and easel, but with words. There are many names which come to mind concerning surrealism itself. These were poets, writers, thinkers. One example is Wilhelm Apolinary Kostrowicki, Apollinaire. This was a great poet who made his way into the literary world using exactly this alias, Apollinaire. He died as a result of wounds suffered during World War I, even before the creation of surrealism. Nevertheless, the name and ideology stems from his mind, this attempt to detach from reality. Another example is André Breton, also not a painter, yet a poet, writer, philosopher. They together created the basis of surrealism as a revolutionary way to escape reality. This attempt to escape or detach oneself from reality is a prominent motive in the 20th century.
Ta ucieczka od rzeczywistości będzie nam jeszcze wielokrotnie w XX wieku wracała.
Tak, zdecydowanie tak. Warto tutaj też być może przywołać na zasadzie pewnej.
The end of the 18th century, the 19th century, as well as the first half of the 20th century were all dominated by German philosophy. This highlighted an attempt to focus on one's mind and understanding as a basis for creating reality. In Immanuel Kant's theory, reality is inside us. Our senses are a mechanism which allow for making sense of what we ourselves perceive as real. It could have been described as being in a world of self, a world of understanding. It seems that surrealism was appealing to these theories that what was situated in one's mind was the most real reality in layman's terms. The Surrealist Manifesto was presented by Breton in 1925, 1 year following the establishment of the scripture. At the turn of the 20th century, it could be seen that artists would group together and focus on creating and establishing means of artistic expression. It could be seen, for example, with Pablo Picasso and Georges Braque, Vincent van Gogh and Paul Gauguin, Impressionists, the Barbizon School, all artists working together in their art movements. This also had an effect on surrealism itself. André Breton was seen as a sort of a dictator of the movement. He was making all of the major decisions, banishing members.
Formuła surrealistów jest nieco inna. Otóż Breton jest takim właściwie dyktatorem tego środowiska.
Wyrzuca ludzi.
Wyrzuca, tak.
A great deal of brilliant artists, for example Salvador Dali, were banished from the movement.
Salvador Dali zostaje wyrzucona.
Tak, bezceremonialnie.
It was almost as if he decided himself that he would be put at the head of the artistic movement. From the perspective of art, this situation was almost comedic, as he was banishing the most representative artists. It is very interesting, however, as situations like this were great depictions of the movement itself. It seemed to be similar to a combat unit.
Charakteryzujący to środowisko.
Ruch surrealistów jest od samego początku praktycznie silnie związany z partią komunistyczną. Oni w pewnym momencie wstępują do francuskiej partii komunistycznej.
Or a unit of the Communist Party. Surrealism, from its earliest days, shows a great tie to the Communist Parties, with members joining the parties as well. They believed themselves to be at the forefront of the revolution, the physical one as well as the artistic one. When speaking of surrealism, one must remember that art, in this period of time, was used as a tool to represent ideologies. These ideologies were violent, countercultural, and prevalent across the globe. Now, however, let us focus on the artistic layer. During my historic education, I first stumbled upon the works of surrealists, for example Salvador Dali, which made a great impression on me. It was later that I learned of Hieronymus Bosch's late medieval works. I remember thinking, was Hieronymus Bosch the first surrealist, which created his art many, many years ahead of Dali? Or did surrealists jump into a time machine and go back to the late medieval ages?
I przenieśli się na moment do późnego średniowiecza? Jak to jest?
Rzeczywiście nie tylko Bosch, bo przecież Bruegel, który jakby wszedł w ten obszar wyrazowy.
That is a very valid point. Peter Bruegel and Giuseppe Arsimboldo also created art in a similar style to what was known as surrealism many years later. The only thing to remember here is that these artists were simply making use of cognitive understanding. This was nothing out of the ordinary. This could also be seen in ancient Egypt, the body of a lion and head of a human. It is a natural attribute of a person who is curious and eager to discover and explore the world. Naturally, we try to understand and comprehend information, and next, this information is toyed with in such a way. This method of creating art was not very prominent throughout the years, yet could have been met here and there. It was just during Surrealism when it was at the highest point. Impressionism questioned Latin tradition and means of expression, the means of referring to reality. It questioned the formal planes, for example, by means of using the chromatic scale, by applying paint in a different manner. Surrealism, especially Dali's surrealism, took advantage of the formality of the artistic movement and only ever slightly modified the form itself. It was still, however, a means to question and distort what had already been established.
Wykorzystywała formalno-warsztatowe środki, a modyfikowała jedynie formę.